Thanks, little guy.
Ding-ding.
Oh, thank you.
Ding-ding.
Did I miss something? When did we get to Disneyland?
Ding-ding.
So anyway, this is the tweet that Dave Filoni sent out congratulating Deborah Chow. Hey, it's Stephanie, your friendly neighborhood barkeep, bar manager, Wookiee Wrangler, chaos coordinator, bringer of news, opinions, things like that, Raylo Slayer. Today I want to talk about the addition of director Deborah Chow to the Star Wars universe. She will be directing the Obi-Wan series. Now, I am not too thrilled with the Obi-Wan series because to me it's just doing nothing more than fan service. I know Ewan McGregor is going to be one of the major league producers. I don't think it's going to be woke. Okay, listen to me. This woman has a really great resume. And it looks like she was hired by very serious people. People who want to get things right. So we'll see. The thing that bothers me so much is they wait till now to start doing things right. Destroy Han, destroy Luke, you know, and of course, you know, will they decanonize Solo, a Soy War story? No. They'll let that shit just sit there and fester like a rotting cow patty in you know, the Florida sun, okay? You know, they won't. That's what pisses me off about this, but enough about that. So anyway, what does it mean, you know, Feige going over to Star Wars to develop a movie with Cray? Okay. You know, one of the things that I was rather shocked about is you didn't hear anything from Kathy Kennedy saying congratulations, but you did see Dave Filoni. You saw the tweet. I just posted it. Okay. What else bothers me, though? There is some feeling on the internet, within the community, that Kevin Feige going over to Lucasfilm to develop a movie may be bringing Brie Larson with him. So guess what, Star Wars fans? You know, she just doesn't have enough of us shitting all over Marvel. Now she may get to shit all over Star Wars. To quote a friend of mine in Hollywood, one of my contacts, if Brie Larson gets a role in a Star Wars movie, this just proves that Feige's sleeping with her. I'm just putting it out there. It's hard for me to imagine someone with so little talent who takes herself far too seriously for what she actually does for a living would be able to get a role beyond an ad for, you know, sheets filling stations, you know? I mean, come on, man, so anyway, that's a worry, okay? But what Feige brings with him is a seriousness about getting blockbusters made. He knows how to do it. Now, are they good? In my opinion, Marvel sucks. I am not a Marvel fan, I hate it. I liked Iron Man, I have Iron Man in my collection. I really do like Jon Favreau, but I'm not. I do really like and I'm going to go back to Deborah Chow. Deborah Chow, to me, is a really good, like I said, addition. Her resume is solid. She has got way more experience with what she does, which is TV productions, than Rian Johnson had before he made The Last Jedi. I mean, she just does. She is serious business. She's not Carrie Hart by any means. She directed two episodes of The Man from High Castle. If you guys, I know, remember that show. Excellent show. Excellent. She's very much one of the BBC people. So we've got someone who's a little bit probably less inclined to virtue signal. Even British leftards don't virtue signal like this. Now, at least in Hollywood. I mean, you know, you got John Cleese, who's a major league pain in the ass on Twitter, complaining about the politically correct culture. Then you got Piers Morgan doing the same thing. So she might be a combination of one of those things, so that's good. Let's go back to what else is going on. Feige gets along well with Favreau and Filoni. After the blow up argument at that meeting from like what, a month ago now, where Kennedy, I thought it was Pablo, Kennedy told Filoni, if you didn't have balls, you could do your job. Kathy's such a nice lady, and such a goddamn phony. She, you know, this looks like she's basically being taken out of the equation. With Feige showing up, like I said, when you have a serious man doing a job like this, the work environment changes. You know, Kathy Kennedy spent too much time staring at her own, you know, her own physical mechanics to care about actually putting good stuff out. She spent too much time virtue signaling. And that's the problem right there in the nutshell. You know, from what I've been told, she doesn't like Star Wars anyways. She was just using Lucasfilm to hopscotch to being CEO of Disney. Now, is Feige going to be the CEO or the president of Lucasfilm? Probably not. There's still some feeling out there that somebody else is chosen. However, him just going over there to even to develop a film is very telling. Also, this indicates, all of this indicates that Rian Johnson is definitely out. Probably what he was going to be doing, Feige's doing. And that's a smart move on Disney's part. You get the more experience, you get the serious guy. You won't see Kevin Feige on Twitter posting mean memes at the fans when they're angry at him. I mean, Feige's a professional. What else does it mean? It might mean that there's an interim thing going on right now, but you know, there's lots of moving parts and lots of stuff happened this week. The start of October is this week. October is the end of the quarter. October is when all the earnings for the quarter are added up. They'll look at everything and they start looking at personnel. All right, so expect more to happen in the next month. And we've also got, you know, Force Friday coming out. There's a new novel coming out about the Resistance after The Last Jedi, trying to lead everything up to it, to Rise of Skywalker. So that'll be interesting to see. The new poster still hasn't come out, and we should be getting a trailer. That along with personnel changes and stuff like that. So this is stuff I just wanted to tell you guys, hey, this is all this stuff is going on. And, you know, glad you like the funny little anti-Raylo vignettes I put out there. I have more. Just wait till December, because that's when they're going to come out in vengeance. Anyway, I'll see you around the galaxy, see you around the cantina. Please remember, tip the Wookiee bartenders 20%. No droids or bounty hunters. No Raylos, no Ray Nobodies, no Ray Palpatines, no Ray Luke's clone hand. No Ray Kenobi, no Ray clone of Leia. Ray Shmi Skywalker, what the fuck? No Ray reincarnated Anakin, no Ray Immaculate Conception of any kind. All right, this is real Star Wars stuff. Remember, twin sons of Tatooine, there's a hint there. If you're gonna fight, take it out in the alley. Gunfights, you take this shit out in the street. I'll see you around the galaxy.